This video will show you how to navigate Moodle and includes some updates from the new version, Moodle 4.1. In 4.1, menus are located at the top of the site, and you'll use these to navigate. The homepage lists your courses and has a search box where you can search for a specific course. Clicking Dashboard displays a timeline and calendar, and this page is a little bit more customizable because you can add blocks to it. If you click My Courses, you'll see a list of all the courses you're enrolled in. You can star favorite courses by clicking these three dots here, or remove them from view if you don't want them in your list. Resources are still displayed at the top of the site for students, faculty, Moodle, and academic items, and you'll notice various supports and resources within these links. Clicking any of these here will jump to a course. Let's open up a course here. Once you're in a course, a secondary menu appears now for the course settings, participants, grades, reports, and more options. If you want to enable the accessibility toolbar, click your profile icon from the top right of any page in Moodle, and then click Accessibility. This allows you to choose the font type or to enable or disable the accessibility toolbar by checking this box. Once you click Save, you'll see the accessibility toolbar located at the very top of the site above any of the other menus. Here you can adjust the font size or the site color that's used throughout the site in Moodle. In the new version, you'll notice the edit mode is here at the top right, and you can toggle editing on or off by clicking this button. The blocks are still located on the right side of your course page, and can be expanded or collapsed by closing the block drawer here by clicking the X, or expanding it by clicking this burgundy arrow. You can also add a block by clicking this button here at the top. One of the new features in Moodle 4.1 is the course index. So on every Moodle page, it's a collapsible drawer now located on the left side of the course that lists all of your course sections and the activities and resources within them. You can click the X at the top to close the course index, or click this burgundy button to open it. Clicking on any item in the index jumps you right to that item. So it opens up in the main content area, and from here, if we want to return to our main course, we can click the title of our course here in the site header. Activity icons also got a little bit of a revamp. If you click Add an Activity or Resource, you'll see that all of them have different colors and icons. On the course page, you'll notice that they have a little bit of a different view because they are now displayed in buttons. These can be dragged and dropped, just like in the other versions of Moodle. Activity names are still displayed here now when edit mode is on. So you'll notice things like forum, URL, and quiz only when editing is on. One other change. Labels are now called text and media area. They function the same and can be used to display headers, images, or other contents, or to break up different activities in a course. When adding a new text and media area, you'll notice that there's a different text editor or an updated version that's used across Moodle. The Tiny MCE text editor is shown everywhere in Moodle where faculty or students enter text. So they're shown when you're adding an announcement or a forum, grading, answering questions on a quiz, etc. This new toolbar has several improvements, including updated menus here at the top, and a lot of different options now, including ways to insert tables, code, equations, and lots. The updated text editor is demonstrated in a separate video. That's a quick overview of Moodle 4.1. If you have any other questions, please reach out to us in the Teaching and Learning Hub, and we're happy to help.